percent of the overall score. The ice dancers, of course, must skate in three phases of the competition: the compulsories, the original dance, and now the free dance. It's 4 minutes long, and here is the young team I just mentioned: Lauren Gallo-Rabinowitz and David Mitchell. They won the novice national title back in 2000, and then won the junior national title in 2002. And here they are in third.
Represent obsession. He's trying to seduce her. She's trying to push him away. So a power play.
Figures. Lauren is 17 years of age from Brookline, Massachusetts, and David is 21 from Cortland, New York. They train in Boston.
Free dance, there are 5 to 7 lifts and 2 step sequences, one circular, one's diagonal. Look for turns on one foot called twizzles and dance spins.
Good debut at the senior nationals last year. They just missed the podium. They came in fourth, skated in the Grand Prix circuit. Some great international experience this year at Skate Canada, the NHK trophy, and they admitted they were a bit intimidated at first.
And if they get to do it all again next year, it'll be a whole new story. Once you gain that experience, you start to gain your courage as well. Stretch through their leg lines and body lines. I just like to see them become more aggressive in their pushing and vary up their body movement more to create, I guess, more dynamic.
With a young team, I'm sure it's different to a certain extent with every team, but are there certain aspects of ice dance that you see lacking or things you need to work on with young teams in general?
A lot of it is just that holding back, not exploding, using the best part of your blade, holding back, and just sort of a shyness and expression that shows immaturity. That's why Belvin and Augusto are kind of interesting. They've sort of broken through that. And Lauren and David are the same age as Belvin and Augusto. Footwork is very nice, their movement is well thought out, but the intention of the program isn't shining through because they don't have that power and that explosiveness.
You watch figure skating and ice dancing on television, it's all sequins and flowers, but these two get up every morning at 4 a.m. They're on the ice by 5 a.m. They train for a few hours, then head to a full day of school before returning to the rink at 5.
Because they're very well-rounded people, great kids, and they're solid skaters, just slightly tentative at times.
Which you would expect, perhaps, at this point in their careers, but they are in a position to maybe make it to the podium. They're in third. Right now, we'll see. Lauren Gallo-Rabinowitz and David Mitchell.
Their skills in lifting are actually quite good. This is a change of direction lift. He's in a spread eagle, a low-lying move for her, a lot of control. They work through many different positions. Here she's in a stag, an extension. He's again in a different spread eagle, riding on a different curve. So the control, very good. Their steps are nice. You can just see that the upper bodies aren't quite lifted. There's sort of a sluggishness in their pushing, and these are the areas that they can work on.
There's a look at the panel of judges. There are 9 of them working the State Farm U.S. Championships. The old traditional system, the 6.0, is in play here, not the Grand Prix system that we saw, international system, which is new. I was just getting used to that. Now I'm going to go back to this. First set of marks now, technical merit. And there they are, 4.9, the low mark up to 5.4. 5-2 and 5-1. About what you expected?
Yes, they seem quite right.
And presentation now, 5.2 up to 5.6. Maybe tough for those to hold up, but we'll see. You never know. Keller Rabinowitz and Mitchell. It's a golden moment to shine now for